everybody, welcome to another episode of Fishkeeping Jamaica Rally here. Now, today I was intending to give you a follow-up with regards to my koi that I have been measuring the growth of my koi, the two koi in which you have probably seen at the start of this video, right? These koi were bought a few months ago, when which I said that I would check to see the growth rate between both that which is in the aquarium versus that which is in the pond. Now, upon checking, I'm sorry that I'm unable to actually catch the fish right now, because as you can see, it's a very large container, but I can see it, but probably you can't. But practically the size of the fish remains the same as, well, not remains, the size of the fish is practically the same as that which one is inside. Now, a point to note as to the factors which may have led to all of this. And you might be wondering, what am I doing? I'm going to explain all in short order. Now, what you must understand, that koi along with goldfish secretes a chemical compound which actually tells the body, well, it had actually retards the body if not disposed of at a regular interval. The chemical that is secreted from the koi and the goldfish can retard the growth of the fish. So your koi will be in a tank for several years and you realize that the koi is not growing. One of the reasons why the koi is not growing is that, one, the amount of chemical that have been released by the fish in the aquarium is not being removed on a timely basis. Now, my fish in the aquarium in my home practically have the same measurement size when compared with the naked eye. I change my water within my aquarium inside on a regular basis, right? The water for this pond is also changed on a regular basis, but I want you to realize that the water in this pond is so much that it will take a very long time for these fish to actually secrete so much hormones or chemical, whatever you may call it, that would inhibit the growth of these fish. So therefore, when I do a 80% water change, like for last week, right, and I'm not going to do another one until probably the end of the month, I might do another 40% water change or something like that, right, the amount of hormones that is secreted within the pond by the fish is not sufficient enough to inhibit growth. However, being in an aquarium, the hormone level will be higher than being in the pond. Why? Because the aquarium is usually smaller in size than the pond itself. As a result of that, koi and goldfish never usually grow to their full size whilst in an aquarium or tank. A goldfish, if kept in a very large container, water is changed very regularly, can grow into the feet. I mean, like 1 foot, 2 feet, right? Or even more. Right? A koi, goldfish, you know, koi can grow up to 4 feet, 4.5 feet. If water is changed properly, and if they are taken care of properly, they are fed properly, and there are no health issues. Now, the koi goldfish in my pond is similar in size to the one that exists in my aquarium inside. It will take several months for it to reach to a level where in which the one inside will be retarded in growth, because after a while, after a couple months, I'm gonna have to be changing water on probably a daily basis. This daily basis is is impossible for me to maintain. So while it requires me to do daily water changes for my koi and my goldfish inside as they grow, right? It will not require daily water change for my pond outside. So as a result of that, the pond outside, the fish that is in the pond outside will tend to grow much larger than the fish in my aquarium. This exercise is not one in which can be seen within a few months, but rather a couple of months, well, probably even years, right? So because I have knowledge of all of this and I do not want a fish that is retarded in health, after about probably about the next 2 months, I intend to remove the koi fish. I intend to move the koi fish from inside of my house to this pond. But this exercise was just to share with you the fact that the size of the pond, right, regulated by water changes, could be okay for your fish if you have the time, if you have the resources to change water on a daily basis. I mean, you can keep a goldfish in a bowl, although that to me is cruelty. You can keep a goldfish in a bowl, but you know you're going to have to change water like once every day or once every other day, right? Because the goldfish excrete a lot of waste. Now, with regards to why I'm placing my water lilies in the containers over there, I did 80% of water change. And for those persons who did not know, the goldfish and koi tends to be encouraged to spawn whenever water changes occur. Whenever the water is clean, they tend to spawn, right? Very frequently if there's egg within the female, right? Sometimes the female will tend to hold the egg because the water is just not good, right? So I did a 80% water change last week, and I found some eggs as I was shifting around the plants a while ago, right? I had expected this, but I was considered within myself that I should not remove them because I had the issue with the toads. However, last week I discovered where the toads were being where the toads originate. So I destroyed that area. So for the entire week this week, I did not see any toad in any of my ponds, right? I mean, the place was like it never exists, right? I never had the problem, right? I came out here in the night, I check in to see if I see any of the toads, right? They're gone, right? Some nights I'm out here killing like all, well, probably you might take offense to the whole idea of killing, but destroying 33 tadpoles, right? But they actually go into my pond and they consume my fish, especially my flies, right? And they are really annoying, right? Because I could have had more stock within my swordtail, but they have been consuming them. So therefore, I actually decided to try again, because I got some flies a few weeks ago from my goldfish. They were hatched and everything, but probably about 25. They were hatching everything, but I said that I was going to allow them to stay for another week to get their strength, because I do not like to move flies when they are too young. They tend to have issues. So therefore I allowed them there, and the toads actually came into the pond and actually consumed all of them. This is Riley here for Fishkeeping Jamaica. I hope that this video was of interest to you. Remember to subscribe, share, and like. Jamaica, Irie, thank you very much. Bye-bye.